All right, we're going to now talk about the relationship of elasticity to revenue, which is on our second tab in the spreadsheet. Revenue is the quantity that's purchased times the price. So revenue is indicated by this number. That's the price times the quantity purchased. And I'm doing this with a different shaped demand curve than I had before. Before I had 100 and 100 as the intercepts. Now I have 120 and 60. The slope of this thing is minus 2, and the slope of its reciprocal, therefore, is minus 1 half. And I just want to show that the results really don't depend on the slopes. I'm going to use a different type of demand curve. We are representing the revenue by this rectangular area. So that, again, is got height equal to, let me undo that, height equal to the price, and the base is equal to the quantity. So the rectangle here represents the revenue that's obtained. And at this particular price, the unitary elastic demand curve through the point is flatter than the straight line demand curve through that point. So demand is inelastic at this point, and demand elasticity is minus 0.36, very inelastic. So what we want to know is what happens when we raise price. Does revenue go up or go down? So let's do that. Let's raise price a little bit and watch the revenue number as I raise the price. Looks like it's going up. And that is a definite true statement. When demand is inelastic, an increase in the price raises revenue. And the idea is when price rises by a percent, quantity falls by less than a percent, and so the product actually goes up. Now, let's increase price substantially, and actually, let's get it up here. Okay, so now we're in a region where demand is elastic, and let's do the same type of experiment. And we know it's elastic graphically because the unitary elastic demand curve is steeper than the linear demand curve through the same point. And now let's raise price. And what happens to revenue? It goes down. So when demand is elastic, raising price lowers revenue. Okay, and now let's try to see if we can find where the revenue maximum is in the curve. Anybody want to guess what the demand elasticity at the revenue maximum is? And you can see we're getting closer to it. And it turns out demand has to be unitary elastic at the revenue maximum. And there it is. At that revenue of 1800 is the maximum. And it turns out, because this is a linear demand curve, and again, I shouldn't do that, because this is a linear demand curve, the price at which revenue is maximized is half of the demand intercept price of 120. So 60 is the price that maximizes total revenue. You can probably reason yourself why it's got to be halfway there. Because, again, we want to make this rectangle as big as possible, subject to the fact that the vertex here is going to be on the demand curve. So there you have it.